Hello, and in this video,
we will create a DevOps CI/CD pipeline to deploy a WordPress website in AWS Cloud. For our WordPress, we require PHP and Apache. This is why we use Elastic Beanstalk, which is a service for deploying and scaling web application developed with Java, PHP, Node.js, Python, Zoka, and other services. Okay, first thing is to sign in to the console. We navigate to Elastic Beanstalk here. We create a new environment, web server environment. We give name the DRIF-SRH-THESIS. We choose here platform PHP and application code. We choose sample application and let's click here on configure more option. And here we choose single instance, which is a free tier for AWS for cloud for Elastic Beanstalk. Let's click on create environment. Okay, the environment is successfully created. We will commit the WordPress code to AWS CodeCommit. First thing is to download WordPress code. I'm gonna download it from WordPress official website. And now let's create an AWS CodeCommit repository. We go back here, we search for AWS CodeCommit. Create a repository, we give a name, and let's click on create. Okay, here we can clone HTTPS, and we're gonna paste it in my notes. Now, we need to create an Iam user who has access to push and pull code from this repository. So we go back here, we search for Iam. We click on users. I will add a new user. And here access type I will choose programmatic access. Next, go to permission. I will click on attach existing policies. And here I will search for code commit. And I will select AWS CodeCommit full access. And then I will create the user. We can create the user. Okay, this is our user. We can close this page. We can click on this user. We go to security credential. And here we can click on generate credential. Username, I will paste here, and password, I will paste it here. Okay, close. Okay, now we go to the terminal and we go to downloads and then to WordPress. Okay, we do a git init to convert our WordPress to a git repository. Say git init. Okay, Now we're gonna put our CodeCommit repository as an origin of this local repository. The command is git remote add origin. Let's copy the repository URL, copy, and paste it here. Okay, to verify, let's click git remote show origin. Okay, let's enter the command git status to see the file need to be committed. Those are the files. Now let's write command git add dot to add all the files. Okay, now we are ready to make our first commit. Command is git commit dash m first WordPress commit. Enter. Okay, now we are ready to push our code to CodeCommit repository. Command is git push origin master. Okay, now the code is committed. Can go back to the IBS console. Let's go to CodeCommit. Repository, and here we can see the files that we committed from our local machine. Make a bridge between our AWS CodeCommit repository and the Elastic Beanstalk server. For this, we will need AWS Code Pipeline. Let's search here in the bar AWS Code Pipeline. Here, let's create a pipeline. DRIF-SRH. We have here a new service role, and this is the role name. Let's click on next. This is here we have to select where our source code is. In this case, AWS CodeCommit. The repository name is DRIF-SRH. Branch name is master. Click on next. Build option is for application, Java application, Python application. In our case, we have a PHP application. We don't need a build stage. So skip build stage, skip. And here we have to, we want to say, okay, we will deploy to our Elastic Beanstalk. Let's click AWS Beanstalk, region Europe, Frankfurt, application name, DRIF-SRH-THESIS. And this is our environment. Let's click on next. Okay, his review. Can review the things, and then let's create pipeline. Okay. It will take the source code and commit here to Elastic Beanstalk. Okay, now the deployment is complete. We can go to our Elastic Beanstalk. This is our environment. If we click on the link, we can see our web page is running. We need to make our website live by connecting it to our database. Let's click on continue. Okay, it will say you need a database name, username, password, host. Okay. For this, we will create a database. Let's go to the console. Search for RDS. Let's click on create database. For the engine, I will choose MySQL. For the template, I will choose free tier. For the instance identifier, I will say database.srh. I will keep the username as admin and the password should be more than 8 characters. I will leave availability and durability and the connectivity. I will create a new VPC group. I will select VPC WordPress SRH. And in the additional configuration, it will say, okay, the database port is 33.06.06. And in the additional configuration, I will give a database name, database name. I will choose my database H. And then let's click on create database. While the database is creating, let's modify the security group that we created to allow incoming traffic from EC2 instance. For this, let's navigate to EC2. And let's open the security groups. And security group name, this is the security group that we created. Let's select it. And let's open the inbound rules. And let's click on edit inbound rules. I will leave MySQL Aurora, protocol TCP, port range 3306. And here for source, we enter SG for security group. And we'll choose the one that our EC2 is using. Save rules. Okay. Now the database is created. We need the endpoint, so let's open the database. This is the endpoint, let's copy it. And I'll put it in my node. And now let's go to the WordPress directory in our local machine. And we can find here WordPress-config-sample.php. Let's copy and paste this file. And rename it to wordpress-config.php. Okay, let's open this with the text editor. The DB user is admin. Password I created. The DB host is the endpoint. I will copy it and pass it And yes, the database name is my SMH. Okay, let's save it. Click on exit. Now we have to push this file to our CodeCommit repository. Now let's open the terminal. We are already in our WordPress directory. Let's enter the command git status. It will say, okay, this file needs to be committed. That's good. Let's hit the command git add dot to add the file. And then let's commit the file git commit dash m and message okay, now we can push the file. Okay, now the file is pushed. We can see that the pipeline will start again. Let's go to code pipeline. We can see that the whenever the user will commit new change in the code, the pipeline will start again automatically. Okay, the pipeline is done. Now we can go to the WordPress website. Let's click on back, let's refresh. So we say the file wordpress-config.php already exists. Let's click on install now. And we say continue. And now we can insert just the site title, SRH-THESIS. Admin password, let's give a strong password or just this. Confirm use of weak password, email, and install WordPress. We can just go here to the website, go to the services, and this is our website live in AWS Cloud. Okay, thank you for watching this video.